One, parallel coordinates plot. This is not, this is one of our creations, but it is not our idea. This has been done before. The idea behind a parallel coordinates plot is basically taking that arc chart and unwrapping it so each of the columns here represents a variable that data item will have, and each of the red points on them or the columns are a value that that variable can take on. So in the case of cars involved here, this is just a linear axis, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And in terms of pickup van SUV involved, that value is either going to be 0 or 1 in this case, because there aren't that many pickup vans SUVs involved in the incident, for example, for this data set. And for counting, again, we just have these out alphabetically. We actually have an interactive version, so we'll kind of explain a little better through that. It is a subset of a larger application that we put together for exploring accident data in Maryland again. But I'm not going to go into what the rest of the application is capable of, because this is the weirdest part of it. Let me make sure you guys can see everything there. Okay, there we go. Alright. So, again, the idea is to take each event and trace out a line through the visualization, sort of the same way we did with the arc chart, showing what properties that event actually has. So, we can run over one of them. And that line traces out the events that the one event that had the two columns that I selected there in common. So this is basically like the arc chart, it's a little more fully featured. You can drag to fill the things out, so on. So anyone have any feedback on rolling the arc chart and laying it out in parallel? Because the data set we sampled is November, December, January, February. And so there's that big gap in the month number. Any other ideas? Thoughts? Yep. So it's good at analyzing the properties that the multiple properties that a subject can take on. So in terms of just data visualization in general, I've seen a pretty famous example of one of these that uses the nutritional content of breakfast cereals. So you can see things that are high in dietary fiber, low in sugar, you see a pattern there, and then you see the reverse for your fruity pebbles and stuff. You guys have any ideas what other data sets in the transportation world this could be applied to?
Yeah. Any data set that has